Yo, good morning, good morning. This is block number 6, I believe, man. I just woke up. It's like 2 or 3 in the morning, man. I think like 3 or 4, my fault. Man, so like, this is new for me, man, to just wake up and come and blog and talk about something, you know, whatever comes to mind. You know, I'm probably sniffing a little bit. It's cold out here. I'm sitting in the car, got the heat on. But that's my thing, man. I like that I could do this on the go, you know, and not just sit confined to one little spot, one little place, you know. I like to walk around and move and pace when I talk or when I'm thinking, you know. Man, I need y'all to pray for me, man. Since I was young, man, I've always struggled with cigarettes, and man, I struggled with it, you know, with the trees too, but the trees ain't as bad as the cigarettes. I hate it. I seriously hate it, and that's really been hard for me to stop, man. I've been doing it for so long, I don't even want to tell you how long. And right now I'm out here, man. I had to woke up this morning. I washed my face, brushed my teeth, made some coffee. I just came out here and blogged, you know. I don't want to talk about my struggles or my sins or anything that I do in secret, because it's not something I want people to see, and not the image I want people to perceive of me. It's something I don't like, and there's many people that's out there like that, I'm sure, and I don't want to tell y'all about my sins because it might cause somebody to stumble, you know what I mean? It's like the meat, you know what I mean? If you don't eat that type of meat, you know what I mean? I don't want to bring my meat around you, in a sense, you know, it's just a way for me to put it, you know? I know it's biblical in a sense too, but... Man, that's something about me, man. I wasn't raised in the church, man. I ain't never had, like, just some churchly figure or somebody that's in authority in the church. I've never been close to one. I never had one just, like, really just teach me. Like, you know, most preachers' kids, man, they know the Bible, man. The kid, they taught their kid the Bible, man. And the anointing went down to that child, you know. And this ain't no shot at my dad, you know. He just, you know, he never brought me to church. We never talked about God. And ultimately, he is the man that raised me, you know. If I was to get into my story, and I will, eventually, you know, because it's therapy for me, you know, whatever comes to mind. I feel like I really want to go ahead and blow my nose and like start a new strain. Not that, hold on right quick. I feel like, man, sometimes I wake up and I'm just sad, you know, or, you know, I might just be chilling and I'm just sad. Sometimes you ever been just sad and don't know why? Like, it ain't nothing wrong. Everything's cool. You all right. You're content with where you're at, you know what I mean? Because you're used to struggling in life, you know. But when you failed at things, you know, and it didn't work out for you, you know, it's not what you planned it to be. You know, and I know there's a lot of people that's out there like that, you know. You never found your niche, you know. I just want to just encourage you this morning, you know, to just, you know, keep trying. You know, even if you fail, you know, and you didn't find what made you happy, you know. I've given up on a lot of things, man, and it's because it wasn't me. And sometimes I think, I don't want to get too deep into this vlogging or blogging or, YouTubing or whatever it is, and I just don't follow through with it. You know what I mean? Not that I'm gonna give up, but you know what I mean? It's just I find out it ain't for me. You know what I mean? And I would just disconnect as quick as possible, because that's just me. You know what I mean? I like to stay isolated. I like to stay to myself. I like, you know, not having a bunch of friends. I like, you know, I'm a loner. You know, I'm a homebody. I'm a hermit. I can sit in a room and just think. You know what I mean? And what I'm thinking is usually about God. You know, like, I'm so scared that I didn't do what he wanted me to do. You know, and I've given my life since 1999. And I've been up and down, and I have so much to talk about in my testimony, and I can't wait to talk about it. But I have time now, man. I'm recording. You know, as long as I got started, man, what I haven't been doing is behind me. Like, I'm finally doing something, and I'm not doing it for me. I'm doing it for the Lord. Like, Lord, I'm going to step out here, and I'm going to see how many people I can bring with me. You know, and Lord, just bless these people that come with me. You know, they're not going to follow me. They're going to come with me. You know, so that I'm not doing this alone, man. I need friends that believe in God, that want to learn more, that don't feel like they have it all. You know, like, I don't want to try to make it seem like we got it all, man. There's not one person out here that got it all. If you got it all, there ain't no reason for you to be here. I'm going to tell you something. Somebody that I felt like, man, he must have had it all, man. You know, he must have figured it all out, you know, and he did his purpose, and man, God took him away. You know what I mean? And there's people like that in the Bible, but Stephen Darby, you know, if you ever look him up on YouTube, look him up, man. His name's Stephen Darby. Yo, he speak good word, and he told the truth. And I ain't never heard a pastor speak like that. So I respected him, because as I was in my conspiracy world and trying to get the truth, yo, I knew all of this stuff. And then when I finally heard him, I was like, oh my God, this all connects, just like I thought. And it just gave me a deeper connection or deeper mind frame. You know, it's certain great things I don't agree with it. I just don't get into it. I don't get into race theology. I don't get into race. And the reason I don't get into race is because, man, we are all one in Christ Jesus, man. That's biblical. You see what I'm saying? Like, I try not to see black, white, Asian, Mexican. I look at us all as one, man. Like, you are God's creation. How you gonna say, oh, man, nope, it's just for the Israelites, and that's black people. How can you say that when... So who created the rest of these people then, if that's the case, the rest of these races? You know, like, I believe that God has a chosen people, but it's some people in that Bible that don't repent. I don't know if they come from the lineage or the race of Esau, but I'm just saying, man, he hated him. God hated him, you know? And when I think about stuff like this, let me show you how my mind think. Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of beans, right? With his brother, right? Check this out. I was thinking one day, why is it that, and I don't even know how, man, I thought this a long time ago, and I don't see how nobody else don't think this. Man, why is there snakes, when we're talking about health? Why is that your symbol? I'm curious to know. I need to know. And it's at your stomach. Ha. I don't know if you get where I'm going, but I'm gonna leave that alone, cause y'all, that probably went over y'all head, cause the way I explained it. I told you I speak with the art. You have to get to used to the way I speak and the way I pronounce things, or the way I articulate it in my mind frame. Like, I need time. That's why I don't want to really truly go on anybody's platform, because I'm not going to get a chance to speak. Man, I listen to the way y'all cut each other off, man. I wouldn't have a chance to get off what I got to say, man. I can't share the stage with 10 people at a time and they all got something to say. You know what I mean? I could do it one at a time, for real. You know, and I'm making, like, just like how, hey, I know I was speaking his name a lot. Good Lord. I don't want to sound like I'm some fanboy or, you know, anything like that. I'm just saying, when I look at shows and how things are presented in format, you know, I like call-ins. I really, truly like call-ins. But it's some people that just can come on the panel out of nowhere and you just vibe. You know what I mean? And that person is welcome, man. You see the chat, like what he's saying. You know, they still clowning, though. Don't get me wrong. Because, man, the chat is brutal, boy. I can't go on I can't go on nobody's platform and your chat just really abuse me, man. I can't deal with it, man. Like, y'all be trolling, man. Cold. Just cold. Because I'm one of them, I know. So anything that I say, I'm going to say me too. Like, I play the part. I'm childish. I like to laugh. I like to have fun, man. But I'm a loner, man. You know, I'm not one to, you know, like, okay, let me just explain something, okay? Like, last time that we had a panel, well, a server. I don't know how we ended up with the server, but we had a server. I don't even know how I ended up with it at the end. But anyway, what I'm saying is this. When I was leading with that server, I didn't develop, like, special relationships behind the closed doors, talking to people behind each other's back. And I don't like the text message that I could sit up here and talk about you right behind your back while you talking to somebody else. You know, me and somebody else, we sitting up here text messaging you, and you don't even know we're talking about you. You know, and I think that's just wrong. So I try my best that I try to keep it in the public. If we gonna do something as a group, everything gotta be done as a group. You know what I mean? Like, it shouldn't be no backdoor deals. You know, it's just some snaky stuff that happens, and then you get people to disagree on, and then once they disagree, then the whole group is, you know, at stake. And when the whole group is at stake, then, you know, you got to pick the group is forced to pick a side. You know what I mean? And I just, you know what I mean? It. So anyway, I'm going to leave that alone too, man. That was just something that came to mind. And, you know, I want to build a group, you know, but I want to do everything public. I don't want to be trying to, you know, I don't know. Maybe because we was offline before, that's different. And now, you know what I mean? I don't know what this is doing. I'm finna just start doing this little journey. I don't know. I'm blogging. I'm just talking. I figure it out, you know. But I'll be able to go back and hear what I'm saying and correct myself or, you know, go deeper in depth into what it was I'm saying. You know, this is just my thoughts getting out because my thoughts are starting to haunt me. You know, I got a friend. He's gonna call one day. Watch. My coffee cold because I'm just talking. But anyway, I got a friend, and we talk every Friday. We talk every Friday. I'm not gonna tell you who he is or what, nothing. But we talk about it, and when we talk about the foolish servants. When we talk about that story, you know, or the foolish servant, you know, he makes a great point, man. And he just, man, I can't wait for him to call because he drills in. I love to hear him speak. You know, he teaches really well. You know, I have so much I want to learn, man. And, you know, when I'm able to just really just fluently speak it like I want to speak it, man, it's going to be beautiful. And I just know that all it takes is just me continuing on doing what I'm about to do right now and what I'm doing. And I don't know, some way, somehow, I feel like I'm gonna develop the skill, I'm gonna develop the craft, I'm gonna develop, the education or the experience, I'm not gonna just sit and have that skill go to waste. There you go. Oh yeah, man. So my equipment just got a text. It's on the way. So look, that'll be here. And man, I'm gonna try to get myself right, man, to get in front of the camera, man. That to me is kind of uncomfortable. That's truly uncomfortable because I'm just really I don't. That's my space. You know what I mean? And I'm not one to sit and look in the mirror all day. And. But it's cool, man. I'm not doing this for me. I'm doing this for the Lord. I don't care what people think I look like. I don't care what people think, it's about. You know what I mean? Like, I'm gonna show you how to convict a person's heart. You know what I mean? From just being yourself. And I'm about to convict hearts out there. I'm really about to try to stir some stuff up. And I'm sorry, I'm a controversial dude. And the some of the people I know is controversy just as well, but I need people to try to be as respectful as possible as we continue to go forward. We need to be careful on how we speak, and we need to speak with power and grace. You need to show some mercy, that's just what it's going to be, but we are all going to be getting whooped ourselves, you know what I mean? Because that word is going to break us down. I think a lot of people is afraid to look in that mirror, so I look forward to going forward, man. This is blog number 6. I'm just speaking, trying to get some thoughts, man. My hands is cold. I ain't even gonna lie. My hands is real cold right now. I've been going back listening to a little of the of the material that I do have, and I see the short ones, and then I see the longer ones, and I'm like, dang, man, yesterday, my last blog, I did 30-some minutes. I was like, dang, I didn't even know that, you know what I mean? And, it's like going to the gym, you know what I mean? If you got somebody that's gonna go with you, you're gonna continue to go. But when you go, you're going to get some results. But you got to continue to do it. You know what I mean? And then you'll be able to go longer. And I'm feeling like, man, that's what it felt like. Like, dang, I did 30 minutes yesterday. And I could have kept on going. And what I've been doing is just videotaping it and then sending it straight to YouTube. But YouTube is slow with uploading my material, which I'm thinking, man, am I beating the machine right now? Like, because I could have kept on going, man. I forced myself to go to sleep and everything. Like, man, like, I'm going to wake up early and I'm going to jump on it. I don't know what I'm going to say. We just going to roll. Let's just keep on rolling, because this is therapy for me. I'm a real passionate dude. I got a little bit of experience. I feel like I'm a good dude. People will receive me. I'll be liked, in different categories of society. I'm telling you, I'm about to get the love, and that's all I want. I just want the love. I don't know nothing from you. Like I told you, man, look. See, I like that I can go back because I said stuff that I remember. Hey, like I told you, if you're a producer and you hear something real and the stuff that I'm saying on these streams and these blogs and stuff, or, I'm not going to say for the show, the shows when we start doing shows, because I don't know how people feel about their voice being put out somewhere else. But, hey, if you're hearing it and you want to cut some stuff up and you want to make it into something, yo, do that. That's and do it for the Lord. Don't do it for me. If you're a producer, you hear something, man, hey, I'm telling you, you can have whatever you hear in my voice. I think that's a blessing. When it comes to music, I just always felt like, our voice is an instrument, and I try to, man, I miss the music, I ain't gonna lie, I do. But I'm gonna do music blogs or something, you know. I go back to the days with it, man, because I feel like there's somebody out there that's been through what I've been through with that, you know. And then when you look at these rappers today and the way that they're dying, you know, at a faster rate, you know, I don't know. I told you guys that I don't really like watching live TV no more, or TV just in general. You know, I don't know if you ever seen, have you ever seen the series Empire? Okay, so it was some truth to that, to me, you know what I mean? And I think it's a lot of symbols and a lot of signs and a lot of everything in that, that film. So check this out. there's a point in that series where, like, the artist, the music artist, was doing live streams, and it was just about getting the numbers up on the streams, right? You know, that do it for the gram type thing. You know, people have a image to keep up with, you know, in the social media light, right? So check this out. That's what it's gonna be about. Concerts and stuff. I feel like everything's gonna be live streamed. You don't have to be there no more. You know what I'm saying? Here it is. This dude's in a business meeting for a record company, and he's doing a live stream, live concert. You see what I'm saying? You looking at your people in the chat. Like, the chat is the audience, yo. People could buy your music on demand right then. Song just released. Straight from the studio to the market. You know, song just released. And I'm talking about people are donating. People are buying stuff. You know what I mean? Credit cards, whatever. You know what I'm saying? They're just out there like, I buy this music, I downloaded it. You know, or... I'm sorry, man. I'm going to smoke this cigarette. I'm sorry. I have to. Because my nerves just be bad, man. Y'all don't know what I go through. You know, and... Anyway, I want to finish going there, what I was saying with that. I watch how people just go from me. I watch how people just do that. And it's like, man, it's people out there with money that they don't even have to, they don't even know what to spend it on no more. Why not spend it on a person? You know what I mean? I'm like, yo, I don't know how far my videos is going to eventually go, but I'm going to put my Cash App with it. I ain't even going to lie. And you can sell me. Just because you got it, and I may don't, you know what I mean? But I'm putting my own money towards this. I'm putting my own time towards this. I want to treat myself to certain things, and I'm treating myself to trying to reach the people. So I'm not like everybody else. I'm not that dude, you know what I mean? I don't need the money. Man, God has been good to me, man. Y'all don't understand how good God has been to me. I'm telling you, you know, I think I could make it just like this, just talking, man. I don't need help. You know what I mean? I feel like I'm being able to speak to the Lord when I'm speaking to y'all. You know what I'm saying? I don't have to take God out of my conversation. And that's what society tries to do. Like, how do you misplace our Creator? Like, this is the one we need to be going to before we go to ourselves. You know, before we come as a group or before we do anything, like, God's got to come first. And I ain't talking about in God we trust. You know what I mean? I need scripture, man. There ain't no scripture on the money. Huh? Ain't no scripture on the money. Ain't no scripture. I'm sorry, man. I'm smoking, yo. If you are a Christian that, you know, you look down or you judge a person for what they go through, then this probably ain't for you. You know what I mean? This is for those that really got stuff that they're dealing with, you know. I'm finna show you I'm just like you, you know what I mean? But hopefully we'll be able to get it right. You know what I mean? We'll get it right and we'll be able to go before God, you know, blameless, you know what I'm saying, without spot or blemish, you know. You know, we got a wise counselor that's there for us, man. If you ever go through something, man, and you get scared about something, man, if you even see demons, you know what I'm saying, man, just the name of Jesus. There's power in the name of Jesus, man. There's healing in the name of Jesus. You know what I mean? They can't stop us from saying the name Jesus. You know what I mean? And look, I'll be hated by all men for his name's sake. That's what the Bible said. That ain't what I'm saying. So you gonna tell me I need to stop saying Jesus? Check this out, man. It was like that back in the day. Remember when Paul and them was speaking, and the dude went and told. I think I'm sorry. I'm paraphrasing on how this story goes, and I know somebody out there feel me, but I want you to just really put yourself there to think about this. The dude went and told, and the hot officer came out there and was like, "Didn't I strictly tell you not to teach in that name?" What? Not to teach in that name. And look, I'm telling you, you gotta see that, man. Look, I'm gonna bring that verse up. I'm gonna go get the verse, and I'm gonna bring it up in the blog. See that? Now I know that I would be reading, or I'd be opening up the word. I'll be able to eat something. So I'm gonna take y'all on this journey with me, because I'm about to open up the book. I'm not about to, matter of fact, I could go right now and just look it up. You know what? I'll do that. Let me see.